Hey everyone, thank you for being here tonight. I'm trying to see where my camera is. Can everyone hear me well? Can everybody hear me? It's not lagging or anything. I'm in a hotel, so I just really want it to be right. Everything's good. Everybody can hear me. Everybody can see me. We're ready to go. How is everyone tonight? Thank you for being here. We're going to get right into it. Let a few more people get in. Hello, Marilyn. Thank you for being here. Confessions of a Reality Queen. Hello. Go ahead and like the chat as you're coming in. And I put the, hello, everybody. Thank you. I put the StreamYard link in here. So after we go over the topics, if you want to come up and have a conversation, it's fine to come up. Okay. So, all 40 people. Hello, everybody. Y'all go ahead and hit the like button when you come in. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sheila. Thank you all so much. I'm so glad you're here. We have a lot to talk about. Tonight's live is going to be accompanied with Jack Daniel's Southern Peach. It's going to be time to get into it. Okay. Everybody's good. Everybody can hear me. Everybody can see me. Okay. I hope y'all ready. Before I get started, we have so much to talk about. So much. But before I get started, I want to say thank you to all of the content creators who just, I don't want to even name everybody because I know I'm going to forget someone, but you know exactly who you are. Everybody who like had my back or just spoke up after the situation with Marceau, I appreciated it. And honestly, I really didn't mean to do that. It was just so crash. And I was like, he says everything about everybody all the time. So it's time somebody asks him some hard questions. And although it was on TikTok where he had my post hit with community guidelines, I appealed it and they put the post back up. So everything is everything. It did not work. Okay, now that we got that out of the way, we'll get back to it. The first thing we're going to talk about is Lil Bit. And when I say Lil Bit, I mean Candace. Okay, everybody's here. We're talking about Candace Dillard, Bassett Dillard. Candace is the poster child for colorism. Poster child. She is the one who caused it to be to a conversation when I don't even think it really was a conversation, right? I really don't think it was a problem. I think the way Giselle and Robin move, they're just kind of like mean girls sometimes. And I don't think it has anything to do with color. And it could. It could. I just don't feel like that. But she makes it out of a big deal. But then you go and marry a man not of your hue, right? He's not of her hue. And then you get on stage and tell them that they're acting, sitting there with your white blank and your white privileged blanks. But then you get on a public platform and you say that your fear of having a baby is that they will be light-skinned. I don't even think, before we get into it, I don't even think she realizes how many women she offended. How many women she offended with fertility problems. Let's go there. And I'm going to raise my hand because I had those problems, right? I had those problems. And when I got to a certain age, all I wanted to do was be a mother. So if I hadn't, that would have been, you know, that would have been to me. If all you are concerned about is the color of the child's skin, that's what you're concerned about. That's the problem all the way through time. The color of our skin, whether it be light or dark. And then she laughed about it. She laughed about it. So my thing is this. Like a fear is carrying your child out to term. A fear is that there won't be a defect. A fear is that they have 10 fingers and 10 toes. A fear is that you carry them out to term and they live a long life. Not a fear is if their skin would just be beautiful. They don't have acne or they don't have eczema. That's a fear when it comes to skin. That was a fear for me. I had to go through different things for my baby. She has eczema. And I was like, oh my gosh, she's so beautiful. And I saw somebody say, oh, brown babies are beautiful. Absolutely, brown babies are beautiful. I have a brown baby. Beautiful. But she wasn't with a white man. Right? So I was aware that she was going to be a hue. But that never crossed my mind how important that would be. You know what I mean? That is crazy that she would say that. And then the way she ended it saying, it's okay if she's not. If it's okay if it's not. And I know I saw somebody supposed to say, well, that's crazy because it sounds like she won't be good to her kid. Candace will have a problem. She has already voiced it, right? It's already out there for the world to see. I'm not saying that she wouldn't love her baby. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying that if she's in a house of people with a higher hue than hers, she may have a problem. Candace, I don't know if she could just be this sweet, sweet person. I'm sure she can. But due to the fact that she said this out loud and now we all know what her thought process is, hey, now we all know what her process is, her thought process. We don't know. I'm not saying that she would be mean to her child, but she would definitely have some reservations. And honestly, that's honest. Chris said that they talked about it before. It wasn't new to him. What does that say about both? What does that say about both of them? But honestly, what can Chris say? What can he even say? If Candace feels like she's worried, pause, my bad. Let me rewind. Candace is not having a baby. Let's just start right there. Candace not having a baby by him. If y'all remember how Candace was in the beginning of this whole show and she was dead set against kids, now we know why she didn't want to have children. Now she gets on TV, fast forward to this season with these cry angles. Oh my God, I want to have a baby. We have kids in the freezer. Girl, you just said you didn't want to shave because you want to keep Chris away. Hey, everybody coming in. We're talking about Candace Dillard Bassett. Hello. Thank you all for being here. Please like the video. Oh, I have to say this. Everything I'm saying is alleged. No, well, everything I just said was not alleged because it was her word. So everything I said was not alleged. These are in my opinions, though, at the end of it, my thought process. But what I've said at this point is not alleged. But what I will say later may be alleged. And it's for entertainment purposes only. But that is crazy. Insane. So we know how she feels. We know exactly how she feels. So I honestly, truly do not believe that she wants to have a baby. I don't believe that. So we got that out of the way and we can talk about it later. Let's move on to Portia and Nene. Okay, wait, before I go to Portia, let me say something to Sheila. Sheila, I don't know where you live in the world, but my baby has it, had it, dealt with it. Go to a black dermatologist. I mean, in moments, like in a week's time, what she needed, she got, and I saw the difference. even the color, we have something for the color of her skin to even it out. So just do your research and go find you a black dermatologist first and do your research, and you and your baby are going to be so much happier, because I am. Girl, that was stressing me out. Okay. On to Nene and Portia. Wait a minute. What Dun Dun say? In my wonderful voice, everything is legend. I'm gonna leave this up here, Dun Dun, for right now. Everything is a legend in what I think. Oh my God. That is so true. I'm with you. I'm with you on that. Okay. So as y'all coming in into the chat, welcome. We just talked about Candace from the Real Housewives of Potomac. We are now on to Portia and Nene. Okay, Portia and Nene. Why would Portia do that? Why do you think Portia would go out, hang out with Nene, and get to the work part, and you've worked with her before? Do I think she said it? You know what? I do think she said it, because we have not heard from Portia. Let me say that. Portia will post everything. Has she even made a post since Nene has said this? That's the question. She hasn't even made a post. Right, see, she has not confirmed it. She has not made a post. She has not said anything. Nothing. So I hate to make that type of assumption, but I'm gonna have to go with she probably did say it, because she hasn't come out and said anything else. Oh, wait a minute. I got something for that. Hold on. Wait a minute. Who is that said that? Portia has been posting up with Shamia like she could care less. Let me tell you about that, Alf Mac. Okay? Allegedly, I got this from Michelle A.T. Alien Brown the other night. Last night, to be exact. Portia is actually, allegedly, she and Shamia are filming in L.A. I have it written down. Portia is filming by herself in L.A. She's been filming for a month in Los Angeles. I don't know why. I don't know why she's been filming out there by herself. But that's why she's been out there with Shamia. Because allegedly, the word on the curb is she's filming for the Real Housewives of Atlanta. I don't know why she would be filming by herself. I don't know why. But the thing is, De Havilly, that was before the situation with Nene and Portia, was before Simon and this new lady. Whatever she said, whatever they said she said that. Yeah, I'm with you on that. In your opinion and allegedly. I like that. I love that. But why would Portia be filming by herself? Hey, Michelle. Why would she be filming by herself? Why would she be filming in LA? And I'm just saying alleged, because I heard Michelle talking about it last night. And something else Michelle talked about. Oh, I didn't see that, Betty. What did Portia say? Because I haven't seen anything Portia has said. Nothing. I have not seen anything. Nothing. So another thing that Michelle touched on was She's scared to hit hot Atlanta coming, burning bridges. And you know, Kenya is ready for Portia. Kenya is ready for Portia. With all of this that's out now, if they are filming, if Portia is filming, Kenya, and allegedly, the word on the curb is Kenya is already upset because Portia is already filming in LA by herself. Now, you know Kenya's going to have a problem with this. You know that. You know she's going to have a problem with it. So, but speaking of Kenya, yeah, it was before because he just popped out with this woman 2 days ago. He just popped out with her 2 days ago. But speaking of Kenya, even though she may be mad at Portia and she may have some fire, hot fire for Portia, Portia can also have some hot fire for Kenya. So I don't know how y'all feel about this, or I do know how y'all feel about it. But Kenya's salon is still not open. I'm just saying, if you I just don't even understand that. It is still not open. It is still not open. Michelle, she made a post. Kenya made a post that it was supposed to be open March 5th. That is not the fall. Everybody came for me. Millie Chan, why are you exposing somebody? I wasn't trying to expose. I'm making content. It's going to be open in the fall. Candy came out. This lady doesn't know what she's talking about. Kenya's thing is really open. She's renovating, blah, blah, blah. Well, the part that they're talking about that she's renovating, she said it was going to be open March 5th. Michelle had an appointment March 7th. She showed, and you can go over to her page. She got the whole video. She showed up. Doors locked, box on door. Now she got white couches. Now, when you saw the little video that I had when I was looking between the window like this, that video, there was nothing there. But now she has but now she has white couches in there. So there are white couches. So I don't know, child. Uh-oh. I think I need, hold on a minute, y'all. Let me see if I need to do something. Uh-oh. Switch some stuff up real quick. Okay. To make sure everything is everything. Okay. Not fall spring. Yeah. Well, I think she got a contract and she got a peach. So the moolah should be better and sh it should be great. Fall spring is crazy. Let me tell y'all something. I'm gonna tell you right now. When I tell y'all something, when something come out of my mouth on the Millie Chan platform, it's gonna be 99.99999 true. And then ...11111 is because I wasn't there adult. I wasn't specifically hands-on. But maybe Portia have something to go back and forth with Kenya, and Kenya will have something to go back and forth with Portia. But let me say this. I'm gonna put you up here right here, CD. CD said Portia is gonna make everybody step their game up. Now, you might be right about that. because knowing Portia's coming back, it's kind of like Phaedra with Meriton Medicine, right? Everybody, I think they still haven't stepped their game up from Phaedra because they didn't know what to do with her. But what Portia and Shamil was talking about on their camera, if that's what they're going to be talking about, I'm not here for it. I am not here for it. It was corny, goofy, silly. I'm not here for it. I want to see, is Drew coming back? That's a good question. Because you know what? Now I want her to come back. At first, I wasn't too. I didn't know Michelle. I didn't know how I felt about it. But I kind of want her to come. After I saw her at the party with Quad, I was like, yes, we need Drew. Drew needs this. Drew needs to come back. Drew needs to come back. I'm with it. She needs to be here. She needs a platform. I don't know what she's going through. She's been going through a lot. And I think she needs to be back. Okay. Karen had a car accident? Karen Huger? Oh my God. Somebody just said they sent me a link to Karen's accident. Oh no, is she okay? Y'all know I was asleep. Is Karen okay? Do we know if she's okay? While we talking about Karen, it's a bad accident. Okay, Kim, I'll look at it after this live, and I'll have to talk about it tomorrow. She totaled her car. Karen ate with that reunion look. Yes, y'all, please don't forget to like as you come in. Hit the like button. Thank you, Vanessa. Thank you. Vanessa, you see that StreamYard up there? Can you repost the StreamYard for me also? I'd appreciate that. Y'all know I got to get this together. I got to get these mods and stuff together so we can have this thing flowing fluidly. I hope she's okay, too. But she ate the reunion girls up. Like, the Grand Dame was Grand Daming. Yes, prayers for Karen. We hope she is okay, honey. Karen looks fantastic, right? I mean, wonderfully. Hey, Tammy. I thought, you know what? I didn't get to see, when I made that post, I didn't see, like, the look all around. Somebody sent me another video. Okay, I'm going to have to go to TMZ and get it. But I loved Candace's dress. And I did love her dress. I really did. I loved it because I like lace and bustiers and stuff like that. So it hit for me. Oh, Karen was best dressed. You know what? I'm with you, D. Haveley. I hope I'm saying that right. She said after Portia's family matters, Bravo should have cut all ties with Portia. Because, but Portia better come here with some stuff. I love the all black. I love black anyway. I love the all black. So I was all about it. Oh my goodness, Karen. Only you and my kids supposed to leave. Okay, I thought I had posted it in here. Hold on. Let me see. Okay, do y'all see that? That's the link. So, I hope y'all can see it. Yeah, they all look good. CD Real Show. Yeah. Okay. All right. Good. Okay, good. Okay, the next thing we're going to go on to is Love and Marriage Huntsville. I don't know the update with like Here for High Tea and Miss Black Titanic and the anonymous person. I don't know that update, but as far as I know, there was some discrepancies. Oh, good. There was some discrepancies with how Maurice did that. And in my mind, not in my mind, what I read is that what he wants to do is turn it all back around and just drop it. I was like, why are we still filming with them? Like, I was listening to, who was I listening to today? Oh my God, I can't think of her on YouTube. I can't think of her name. But she said, thank you. She said, when, like, if you really think about it, the three men that they have representing Love and Marriage Huntsville are the worst three men that you could find to represent Love and Marriage Huntsville. Marcel is the worst. We really kind of, Maurice kind of had us fooled a little bit until Kimmy got sick and he became the worst. And Marcel has always just been so rude. For him to say what he said, that's why I didn't want to just really say what I said to Marcel, but I was like, Marcel always feels like he can say what he wants to say. He feels like he can say what he wants to say to anyone. Right? I'm going to pull y'all up in a minute after we go through these topics. So just sit tight for a minute. He feels like he can say what he wants to say. And when he said that, I know he didn't say it directly like Millie Chun, go jump off of, you know what I'm saying? He didn't say that, but it was implied. And he came on my page and he said that to me. And I was like, sir, you don't even know who you're talking to. Like, you have no idea who you're talking to. I get invitations to the White House. You get invitations to the courthouse. Don't play with me, Marcel. I am not that one. I'm not one of them. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not even, and see, the thing is, he sits there and looks at me as if, Jamie, what are you doing? Yes, we'll get right there. He sits there up there looking at me because, like, I heard, shout out to Trending at some point. She was like, Millie Chun, it says the least about anybody. Anybody. I do touch on it. I say my little shady. But then I'm off of it because I'm on to something else. Something else has happened. Just like I'm doing this live and y'all done told me about Karen, I got to go talk about Karen. But you want to come after me when you have a person and a blogger who has a whole video out here on the YouTube streets with a woman on here saying that you wanted a 1-2-3 with her. And you mad, I put up a Yelp review. We're not the same, Marcel. We are not the same. We're not the same, sir. Our lives are different. But because I'm a blogger, a content creator, and what Maurice has going on with Here for High Tea and Miss Black Titanic, he wants to put, you know what I'm saying? Like, he feels like he can say whatever he wants to say. My lawyer is international. I'm in South Carolina and I'm covered. And he graduated from a real accredited law school with currently now working with a real firm. Like, he has Esquire behind his name, not LLC. You understand what I'm saying? And that's all I'm going to say about that. Because I got to move on. I was like, you really got me messed up. We are not the same. Just because I don't get out here and say stuff or pop my, I don't have to pop it. I can live it. You know what I'm saying? I don't have to get out here and pretend. You know what I'm saying? Like, I work really hard. I work really hard in the background. I work really hard in the background to make this stuff pop for me. I'm tired right now. But you want to go stand up in and we don't know if it's open or not, and do karaoke with three people in the room. You better get out of here fooling me, Marceau. Let them know. You, sir, we are not the same. We are not the same. I have not. Uh-uh. I ain't never seen no karaoke with three people in the room. And I heard somebody else say, I think the same girl say, how you gonna go out and take your wife out to eat and you take her to Black? You're not paying for that. Maybe you are. Maybe you are. I don't know. I do not know. Okay, let's move on. This is real quick. How great did Fantasia look at the NAACP Awards? Now, I want you to hold on to the NAACP because I got something to say about that, okay? I was going through the winners, and we're going to talk about it. How great did she look? I love Fantasia. Yes, I give light shade. Light shade. Because I don't have time, because I might have to give some heavy shade somewhere else. Her speech was amazing. She looked echo. I'm going back and forth. She looked amazing. All of that. All of that. I'm so proud of Fantasia. I'm so proud of her. You know what, Sheila? I got to figure out how to get this up into a ponytail. If I can get this up into a ponytail, I'm going to go sit in the car and pretend like I'm waiting in the line. I'm going to do it. Her stylist is top tier. Who is dressing her? Who is dressing Fantasia? Oh, child, she made me cry. I sat there and looked at that video, I think, at least 10 times. Me, Nate. Yeah. Yep, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all. You're gonna get it. Okay. All right, let's keep going so we can get people in. Apollo and Phaedra. Apollo and Phaedra. What? I love Apollo and Phaedra. Thank you all. The Big R Invitations are like my favorite. And I was talking to someone about this, like, oh, you say this and you say this about her. But it's her words and this is what I do. But I really don't say anything crazy. I don't say anything crazy. Yes, y'all, hit the like button. Let's get on to Apollo and Phaedra. Tiffany said, wait a minute, let me get Tiffany's post up here. Tiffany said, I thought we'd never see Apollo again. For real. Tonight's live is accompanied by Jack Daniel's Southern Peach. And the peach is peaching. Let me just say that. I can feel it coming on. So I'm my head get loose. It's going to get rough in a minute. Derrickus Crawford is the stylist. Oh, girl, Andy was like, forget this whole reunion. Andy was like, forget it. Andy said, forget the reunion. I got to get up, pause. I got to hug Apollo. Man, I have not seen you in forever. Baby, everybody was gobsmacked. Toya about got up out of her seat. Even Elaine could not say nothing. Elaine could not say anything. Thank you so much. Like, he was salivating at the mouth. And at that moment, you could see the difference in marriage medicine. And even though Pedro was one person and Apollo is one person, with all these people on this show for all these seasons, superseded. It just took over. Yes, Elaine was shocked. Toya was shocked. Andy was just speechless. Apollo came in there and cleared Gregory off the rip. Because while you sit around here trying to say that she was trying to holler at you for $4,000, what did she want for $4,000? She wanted you to have a standard. That's her standard. And then Apollo said, I haven't had no standard. I did other things. Oh, child. I was like, Lord have mercy. I said, Apollo came here and sat down. What is Shireen, Jesus? He said she was cool with it. Can y'all see Apollo next season? Oh, speaking of next season, let me ask y'all a real question. Would y'all watch Marriage Medicine next season? Because it's going to have to be some stipulations for me to watch. Wendy, I bet Apollo can Apollo. Somebody said they're both Scorpios and they both have Greek names, Apollo and Phaedra. Ooh, child. Can you imagine? That's... And let me tell you something. When you got a lion walking behind you, you ain't never got to worry about it. Phaedra didn't never turn around and look back. He got it. Let him know, Apollo. Let him know. Y'all sitting right here talking about where's Apollo, this, that, and the third. Here you go. Girl, don't he know? I don't know if that's the word on the curb, Sonya. He got caught on the ring light. So, but did y'all see how he looked when Phaedra said if she had been on Marriage and Medicine and the way they fight for marriages, she probably would still be married? Apollo said he didn't even know that was an option. It was like you could see his wheels turning. What if Apollo and Phaedra get back together? This just between us. What would happen if they got back together? Oh, Tammy said the last. I know. Phaedra is sometimes she doesn't get the truth all the way out. She doesn't. But she can handle Apollo. And Apollo can handle her, right? Like Shireen, let me tell you something. Shireen held him down while he was in prison, so he needed that. But now that he's out, Apollo is a little unhinged because when they was on that couples retreat, he was rough. But Phaedra know how to handle him. I hope. Oh, this is what I had. Thank you for saying that. Who is this? Who just said this? TJ at TN. I have to say this. Guess who didn't get nominated for best podcast at the NAACP? I'll wait. She said, Phaedra just talking a little Venetia storyline. Reality with the King. I was looking at all of the nominees, and they had a podcast nomination. And I was like, I didn't even realize that. I didn't even realize it until I was looking at the nominees, because I was going to do the red carpet fashions, and something happened, and I just didn't get it done. And then I was going to talk about the nominees, and it just was a whole bunch of them. And I was really looking for Keith Lee to see if he had won. And as I was going down the list to look for Keith Lee, podcasters came up, not even nominated. And then I thought about it. I don't have it here. You gonna have to just Google winners for NAACP, and it'll just give you a whole list, right? And I'm on that other phone, and this phone not plugged up, so I can't get to it right now. No, Keith Lee did not win. He did not win. But wait a minute. Hold on. Yeah, honey. When Apollo walked in, the world shook. Yeah, Shay Shay didn't get nominated either. But the thing is, Carlos has been doing this for a minute. The King of Reality. He's been doing it for a minute. And for you not to get nominated, like Keith Lee got nominated for best influencer. I mean, you're nominated for that. Why wouldn't that get nominated? Because it's messy. And him and Elaine, like, I listened to Toya and Simone because it was Toya and Simone. Because I really don't get into it that much no more. They can't take them seriously. Okay, we are 41, so let's keep going. Quad at the birthday party for Yandy. Y'all, they can say what they want to say about Quad. Let me say this. Let me give you my spiel about Quad. And this is my opinion. Everybody has their opinion. Let's go. I feel like when I heard Mariah talk about it, Quad had an understanding with Mariah that she was going to be right there with her when they started all of this. Once Mariah got the idea of Married to Medicine, and it was really her idea, and not her and Quad's, because Quad was like, she thought she was coming in with her because Quad was going with her cousin. And then, and this is all alleged because this is just Quad, what Quad said. This is back and forth. This is he say, she say. So with her saying when she was talking to Carlos that she felt like it's married to Mariah and things like that, she just felt like she was missing something. Fast forward, she gets with these ladies, she has these situations, and then she just, I feel like Quad put a wall up from Mariah. I feel like it was from Mariah and her situation. I don't know, I'm not sure. But then with everything that was happening, then when she got Sister Circle, and Quad does put her foot in her mouth, because that speech she made at that with those people from those ladies from Sister Circle, that was kind of wrong. You've been on Married to Medicine for a minute, Quad. You didn't have to say that, because some people left. I don't know who left. I think Toya left, or Toya stayed, or Simone left, and Jackie left, or whatever. That was really not right. But then she's really close to Elaine, and Elaine is trying to make TV. Right? Then she loses Sister Circle. So now she got to come back to Married to Medicine because that's all that she has. So now she got to make it right. So Jackie is older. She's an old broad, right? So she sees stuff a little differently. Like, why are you coming around now? You don't have these ladies to back you up. That's not cool. So they handle her with the long handle spoon. Simone is, you know, Simone takes friendship seriously. She's one of those people. And I mean, I get that. I take it seriously too. If I'm your friend, I'm your friend. I'm a vault, right? I'm gonna leave here with a lot of stuff. It's a lot. It's too much. But Quad jumps in and she jumps out. Fast forward to Phaedra gets here. That's her friend. That's her storyline. And I'm gonna tell you something. Letitia and Gregory being on that show, you got to know that that's not easy for Quad. And people want to, then people tell me something. She came on Quad's show. It's not Quad's show. Quad is on the show. Now Letitia is on the show that Quad had been on with the current husband that Letitia had. That can't be easy. But my whole thing is, why does Quad give that so much energy? I have an ex-husband who has a wife. I don't feel the need to say anything. I don't, you know, I speak, I'm cordial, but I do not fill my days with talking about what she's doing. If we were on a show together, I would not fill my days talking about what his current wife is doing. Because I don't care that much. And really, you can't beat me for not caring. And I understand that she has to have a storyline. I understand that she has to do something. But I know we saw Quad in previews with a man. And she introduced him as baby. Let me go back to this. If it was me, when my ex-husband was getting married on the show that I came on with him, I would not be doing a scene in a bathtub. I would have had a scene like she had the other night with all them girls in their pajamas at a party. That's what I would have had. I would have told the producers, I'm about to have a party. And these are the people that I want in attendance. And I want this filmed heavily like you're filming this wedding. That's it. Because only thing that's going on is the wedding and me. Because everybody is at the wedding except for me. So when y'all get over here with me, I don't have no Bath and Body Works in no hot tub, in no tub. If you film me in a tub, you filming me getting out with a towel on, getting ready to host this pajama party. I don't know why they want to air it. I know, Bianca. I just found out. Is it bad? Let me know if it's bad. They wouldn't air it. But why not? Quad needed some airing to go on. Because I don't know how many people are out there who may know Quad in the chat, but what does Quad do? I mean, in real life. Jack is a doctor. Elaine is a dentist. Simone is a doctor. Toya has wine. Letitia works for the government. Is anybody else? What does Quad do? For real, what does Quad do? Child, thank you, Bianca. CD, say that again. Thank you, Bean, because I really want to know. I have no idea what Quad does. But my thing is, if I was Quad, that scene would not have been in no bathtub. That scene would have been me having that party that she had online. Thank you, Mika. That she had online the other night. Now, I don't know what happened to Phaedra's man. Maybe he over there with Quad's man. But that was the whole thing, reason Phaedra was coming on the show. She was dating a doctor. She cooks. Where? Travel. Okay. Y'all know what I'm talking about. So her cookbooks are doing good. Well, that's good to know. I'm glad to know they're doing good. I don't know if she still got that clothing line. But I just feel like I understand how TV, I get it. I understand how it works. You got a call sheet, you gotta sign up, you got to go to these places. In real life, I don't think Quad would have gone to that bachelorette party. In real life, if Quad was feeling how they were feeling, like Toya said that she said she wasn't here for her. She was just here for a check. And then she got on TV saying she was here for her. I don't feel like Quad would have even gone to California if it wasn't for television. That's why I was like, Quad is going to have her own thing going. And she's going to have her group of friends. Because that pajama party, I want to see more of that. I want to see that every weekend. Because even the girlies are in Atlanta. I had no idea her and Toya and Drew and Yandy were close. Rashida. And I want to say that was the McClure twins' mama was in there. I want to say that. I know the producers had her to go, but like, what is, why have been producing like this? That was horrible. Even them sending Quad home was really a bad look. It was just real crazy. And then did y'all hear Simone talking about Elaine? How she said that she doesn't even want to be affiliated with something like that. And Carlos was gagging because this was the most uncomfortable thing for him because they was talking about his girl. And it was nothing he could say. And when he backpedaled, when Simone was saying, you know, she can't do this, he was like, no. Let me tell you, you're right, because we don't need to see this anymore. Like, sir, how you going to explain that to Elaine when y'all get on live Monday? You feel Simone on that, Erica. I feel Simone on that. Because honestly, real talk, I don't even think I'm in for next season. I really and truly don't. Y'all go on Justin Diego Binge Worthy on YouTube. He has put up, hold on. He has put up his dream cast. And the McClure twins' mom is on it. Natari Naughton. Kyla Pratt. Oh, it's some more people. I thought it was fantastic. Okay, wait a minute. Let's move on because it's time for y'all to come up. Hold on. We got people waiting. We talked about Simon. Y'all, what do y'all feel about Cardi B and her 50-50? Did y'all hear that? Because she came back and kind of cleared that up. She said that treacherous. Let me say that. Exactly, Tammy. Cute girl. Your girl is done. I think I'm done. I'm going to have to get into more quality things. But 50-50. How do y'all feel about that? I don't feel nothing about that, Kay. No, ma'am. But he still won't speak to Martell. I know. Like, it's crazy. It's so crazy to me. But let's talk about the 50-50. Do y'all think relationships should be 50-50? Okay. Hey. I feel like... Oh, we'll get to the Tylers. I feel like 50-50 today. Because this is a different day. In 1973, when you could buy a three bathroom home for $79,000 or $69,000, and you were babysitting and your husband was working, I think that's okay. He could handle everything, right? He could handle everything. But I feel like today, unless you are... Even like when it comes to a mortgage, if you can handle the mortgage, I can handle everything else. If you can't handle the mortgage and I'm living in the house, I can help you with the mortgage, right? I may not be able to help all the time. 100-100. I'm with you, Sheila. That's what we're going to end it with. Because you have to have help, right? I know a lot of people like, I'm not going 50-50. I'm not paying no rent. I'm not doing this. Well, you don't want your man struggling either. Because sometimes when they struggle, they go to places that's not struggling. And that may not mean you. Because there are plenty of men who will go to a house that he probably paying a light bill at for peace and quiet, rather than come to a house where he paying the mortgage at to just hear you talk about what you want and you not helping to get it. I'm sorry. So I feel like It is. There's so many factors. There's so many things, right? If you, like Toya was talking about, she's the breadwinner in the home. She says she pays for the boys' schooling. She pays for all the vacations. They go first class. And I know it looks like Toya doesn't do anything because Toya doesn't work on the show. but she's at work on the show when we're watching her. So that's really good. Exactly, son. But Cardi was saying that she's blessed to have that. She and her husband are blessed to have that. But, you know, it's hard out here. But I like 100-100. Like, I'm going to give and you're going to give and we're going to make it work. Let's get to the titles real quick because we got 5 minutes and I'm bringing people up. The Tylers. I think Love and Marriage This Is Over. Winter has already quit. She's already said it. She's not going to be doing those weekly recaps with Ashley anymore. She's not talking about it. Personality speaks. I'm with you on that. Dependent on a need. 100%. Let me post it right quick so it just be up there. I feel like it's over. I feel like Winter has left. I have spoken to Ashley a couple of times. And she is in a different place. Like when last time I spoke to her, she was like, if you pay attention to social media, you'll see how we're moving. And if you pay attention to it, they're not moving together at all. When I spoke with Jamie, I did a live with Jamie. Y'all can go find that under my live tab on my YouTube channel. But when I talked to Jamie before we went live, Jamie is not playing with him. He's not playing with the girls. He is not here for it. And he gonna get them any which way they come. He on it. Hey. And then like, I'm all about people having something to say. I think Love and Marriage DC could really be good with the Tylers, with the Petties, and another couple. I think Ashley is over. And I don't think Ashley is not Millie, but I'm not saying Ashley wouldn't be good. I don't think she's in a good place to be here. I don't think she's in a good place to be here. Let me say that. See, I only followed through. Oh, okay. Girl, this is the lip bar, honey. What's the name of it? I have to get you the name of it. But it's the lip bar. It's the red. It's not the rich auntie. Because the rich auntie is more pink. This is the red. I love it. And it's a matte. Oh, Winter says she's not showing up for the podcast. Oh, you made it. We're about to get ready to come up in a minute. No, this is not Rich Auntie. This is the red one, the redder one. I think I got Rich Auntie. I love Rich Auntie, too. I'm not saying that Ashley and Quick shouldn't be on the show. I think Ashley is having some animosity with some things, the way the show went. And I think right now she is doing some other stuff. She's doing some acting. She's doing some writing. She's making some screenplays. And her mind is somewhere else because that little break just broke them. I like the Tylers too. I really do. Because Jamie gonna get in there. He gonna let it be known. He's going to let it be known. Boss lady. That's it. The lip bar, boss lady. That's it. Well, LaToya, like 100-100. Everybody put in what they can put in. Yes. So, let me see. All right, y'all. Let me go bring this person up if you want to join. Uh-oh. Sian, are you there?
Yeah, can you hear me now?
I can.
Let me turn my TV down. Girl, I want to start with Love and Marriage DC.
Okay.
The way they had, I don't know if that's Ashley's personality or what, but she came across as a superior stink attitude, like, you know, how she did Cliff. And then if you notice, Quick lied. Cliff, I mean, quick lied. He said that Cliff said she was jealous. They were jealous. He said that.
Mm-hmm.
He said that. And
yes, he did. You're talking about Quick? Quick was the one. Yeah. Cliff never said that.
No. And then.
You know what I thought was crazy? I thought that it was crazy that they met to have that conversation. Like, right. Why are you meeting to have a conversation about women?
Exactly.
Why are you meeting for that? And you met Cliff specifically to talk about the Ashley situation. And I know y'all have heard me say this before, and I'm going to say it again. The ladies were never supposed to be going
right
to that basketball game. The only reason that Quick mentioned it was just in a conversation with Ashley. And then she said, I want to go.
Mm-hmm. That voice kills me. Every time she talk, I'm like, oh, Lord. That's that Baltimore. In marriage. How they say married. It's not marriage.
I know it. Let me put this link up here.
Okay.
And then, if anybody wants to come up, I hope it's still.
I was driving to work. Driving home from work, and I said, "Oh, she said she's coming on at 6. Good, I'll be home by then." And then I realized you said Eastern time. You know, we in Texas. I was like, "Oh Lord!" I was in the grocery store with my AirPods on, listening to you.
Oh, okay. Y'all gonna have to go through here, get to the chat, to get the link. I can't even find it anymore. But let me see. But yeah, I just feel like that show is over.
You know, I think if the Tylers, and like you said, the Tylers and the Pettys, and another couple, you know, Winter know where she started. That's why she's trying to shut down on everything. She said it. She don't want to deal with Jamie.
She absolutely said it.
Yep. It's like, you only had that man for 2 minutes.
Yep.
And, you know, she wants somebody to, a man that's going to always agree with her. Well, you don't really want a man, because a man is not going to always agree with you.
No, it's not. It's not always going to happen. It's not always. It shouldn't always happen.
Exactly. And Quick, you know, he's so short. He's scared Ashley going to tell him. Remember, look at your daddy's legs. They're short.
Oh my God. I'm not laughing at that.
Girl, and let me talk about Carlos King.
I'm so disappointed because I had interviewed him early on, maybe 2 years ago. And this was at the top of the time Bell Collective had just really, well, the second season of Bell Collective had come back, and I interviewed him. And he told me some really good things, right? He told me some really great things. And when I look back on it, I'm like, I really want to think that he meant that. But after I see sometimes how he moves, I was like, I don't know if he was just, did he mean, I mean, you know, he was like, he appreciated what I do. He did say that.
Yeah, you know,
he said he appreciated what I do. He was like, and then he talked about the way I create the content that I create, right? And so I was like, okay. And he just gave me some really good gems. He and Jay Bolin, both of them.
Mm-hmm.
And so
I love Jay Bolin.
And so I was like, after it was over, I was like, in the way he is now, because I remember I called Elaine the dentist when I was talking to him, because I was like, why can't you talk to me about Housewives? You talk to the dentist about it. And he was like, the dentist? I said, you have a friend that's a dentist. And I said, go turn around in your chair like you turn around for everybody else.
Exactly.
You know, but I think that that interview with Simone and Toya really had him stuck. It really had him stuck until they start really talking about it. Because see, he thought maybe they was about to sit there and kiki with him about it. But they were like, no, Because when Simone was like, I will leave this show. I'd rather leave than be affiliated with this mess because it's treacherous.
Yep.
That's the adjective that she used, which is a great adjective for Elaine.
Exactly.
Because she was, because I went back. I was like, she wasn't always like this. She wasn't my favorite person on my television, but I could see how she worked in the situation.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I could see how she worked in there.
So it was better when she was heavy set. You hear what she said? She had lap band and tummy tuck and she's still hungry.
See it. You right. Because I'm going to tell you something. We all change a little bit. We lose a little weight.
Exactly.
I got a little weight I got to lose. And I know my attitude going to be different.
Baby. I'm picking up the Manjaro.
When you said heavy set, you almost sent me, I almost choked. That is crazy.
You know, like Luther. We want the fat Luther.
Yeah, he's still mad about that, Sonya. Like, he is still upset. Now, he can sit here and say whatever he wants to say. When Simone called him a blogger, that sent him a little bit and knocked him off of his block a little bit. And I don't want to sit here. Now, I'm not about to spend this time just sitting here talking about Carlos, but I will say this. He has definitely changed.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a need that he's not meeting. And exactly. I feel like he's not meeting our need.
Exactly.
For Love and Marriage Huntsville. I think this is why we mad. I'm just going to say why I'm mad. I'm not mm-hmm. even mad, but just you'll see what I'm talking about. I've been riding with this show since day one.
Right?
I have got invested. I have interviewed male. I have interviewed other people from the show. Invested. Hey, Joni. And then when all of the stuff that's really good comes out,
mm-hmm.
you want to shut down and don't even... We don't care about what's going on Married to Medicine. We don't care about what's going on Potomac. We already watching it.
Mm-hmm.
We want to know what do you feel about Mel with her new network?
Exactly.
How do you feel about, I can ask him some questions like I did Marceau. How do you feel about Arianne Curry spilling your tea because she knows when you come in town and why she can't be on the show?
Exactly.
Why don't you answer our question as to what are you doing with Martell? Like, what is really going on with Martell? What do you think about him being arrested? What do you think about the DV situation?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about the Tasha K interview?
Mm. What do you think about Martell and them lawsuits? Them lawsuits.
What do you think about them lawsuits over there at Black? How do you feel about Marceau? Because I posted it, and somebody under my post, that was like, Ed Carlos King, this is how your people talk to other people. How do you feel about them? Did you tell Maurice to put that thing out on Here for High Tea, Miss Titanic, and the other person?
Exactly, with that fake
account, LLC. How do you feel about that? How do you feel about Maurice not fully acting in his law space correctly because he did not follow the rules? How do you feel about this?
Exactly. Martell don't have nowhere to stay.
Are you quiet because all of this is coming out in the season? See, this is my thing. I don't want you to try to get me caught up in the beginning of the season because y'all, I'm in a season of letting things go. Do you understand?
Me what
I'm
too.
I'm in a season of letting it go. And like, real talk, like on Married to Medicine, Elaine messes the whole show up for me.
Exactly.
If it wasn't for Phaedra and Sweet Tea, I wouldn't even have watched. I wouldn't even know what y'all were talking about. I would have had no idea about Quad leaving. I wouldn't have had any idea about any of it.
Mm-mm.
But I am right here at the helm of Love and Marriage Huntsville. Mm-hmm. And the only reason I stay is because of you all. Because some of y'all don't watch. So I have to watch so y'all can know what's going on.
Exactly. But, you know, I think Carlos,
not some real
stuff. I don't understand his motive of, you know, dealing with all these housewives that he had produced the shows for, but you got fired.
But you got fired.
Or you can't do your people.
Or you left.
Exactly. Mm. Why did they, you know, you trying to be up there like Andy, but you can't because everybody see through your mess.
Exactly. And like, the thing is, I felt like it was coming up to be something like Bravo.
Exactly.
But then it just kind of dropped down for me. I was like, oh, this is not what that is.
Love and Hip Hop, Alabama. Huntsville.
And like, even with Bell Collective.
Exactly.
Okay, in my head, this is what I think. I feel like Bell Collective is not on right now. Bell Collective, by the way, will start filming in 2 weeks. So Bell Collective is not on right now. Why not bring those ladies up and recap the season with them every week? What exactly are you thinking? Like, that's what I'm thinking. Because I literally was literally thinking about, you know what? I need to go and interview some of the ladies from Bell Collective and let's get them back out here. Let's see what's popping. What are they doing right now?
Exactly. I see what's her name posting all the time. She looks great. Marie
just doing photo shoots.
Yes, she looks good.
Marie, what's going on with you right now? What's going on? Are we going to see a ribbon cutting? What's going on with all this? That's literally what I have been thinking about. I was like, I think I'm going to contact some of the ladies and see if they would be willing to do just a little hour conversation.
Yeah, you can have them all up on the show together.
Like, what is Bell Collective doing right now? That's what I would call mm-hmm. it.
Do it. You do it and show Carlos what he needs to do.
Thank you, really, girl. Because I even told him, I was like, y'all need to, what is going on? Like why y'all not out here? Because here's the thing. Mm-hmm. Nobody is talking about Bell Collective. Nobody's talking about Bell Collective can be so good. You want to bring Love and Marriage Detroit? Thank you, Sonya, for putting it on my frontal lobe. Detroit is the worst. And they are filming. Yes. Why are you wasting film on them? She said, I no longer have time to watch a full show. And that's the thing. Just like TJ said, I have to watch the shows because of people like TJ. Because
bad connection.
It's either going to be, she knows right now, it's either going to be 10 minutes or less. She ain't going to have to sit through a whole hour of anything. KB, what you not watching? Not watching Detroit? Somebody, I was like, I know people from Detroit, like, I love y'all. I can call and talk to y'all while the show's on. I can talk to you while it's on, but I'm not watching that. But here it is. They're filming for Detroit. Why not talk to them? Why not talk to the people? Before Bell Collective starts filming in 2 weeks, let's check in with the girls. Exactly, Monica. Is Tamara even coming back? I know some people got their contracts. I know some people got their contracts. I don't know if everybody got them. I don't know. But I will say this. We need to know what's going on. Oh, Sonya, so out of that, the bold and the bougie. So out of that. I watched 1.5
episodes. I didn't watch it. I couldn't. You know, my mind at 60, you just don't have time for this stuff. I cut a lot of stuff out.
Yeah. But that's what I'm saying. Like, what are the girls doing?
Yeah, like, you need to do that, Milton.
And see, that's
you
the
know
thing.
What? You need to do it.
But see, that ain't my job.
But you would show him what to do.
I was like, we need to know, what are they doing right now?
Exactly.
Oh, Lord.
Is Selena coming back?
I'm going to have to get off of here, call somebody, to see if I can interview them Wednesday. And just see exactly. What are the girls doing right now?
Exactly. Because we see what's her name all the time on social media out doing radio stuff. What's her name? The one that had the baby? See, that's how bad that's sad when you don't remember their names.
Exactly.
I know, so Gucci.
Exactly.
And you know, I think he needs to stop with the housewives and get over there and start promoting his show and interviewing people like Marceau the Liar. Let's talk about these lost.
Just interview some of them, that needs to be a group interview. Just put Tisha, Marceau, Maurice, and Kimmy all in one. Just put them in one interview. But that's all we can take is one. I can't listen to them separately throughout a week.
No,
but he needs to do an update. What are they do? What y'all doing right now? Where is Bell Collective? Like, where is Wendy Williams? Where is Bell?
Exactly. Collective? Exactly. You know,
I would love to talk. Somebody said something about Selena. I would love to talk to Selena.
I said it.
I don't know though. I don't know if she'll talk to me, but I would love to talk to her. But
you can get married.
I don't think so.
Oh.
I think she got intentions on it, but I don't think she did.
Oh my goodness. But you know, and then I know it's a TV show, but the kids are back visiting Jay. So, I mean, that would be good to interview the girls.
I'll talk to Sophia. Oh, yeah, we like the Fletchers. But I think I want to start with Akeisha.
They're doing so much.
Yeah, I think I'm going to start with Akeisha and get her back out to the forefront because, you know, her husband and JJ are doing a podcast.
Yeah.
And I think that's doing really good.
It is. I saw a little bit of it. JJ is so crazy.
Why is she dodging me, Tammy? She should be dodging me. Let me say this. Let me say the biggest misconception about me, Millie Chun, as a content creator. I think people feel like I don't like certain people. There's only one person in this whole reality world that I just like the least. And when I say the least, I mean the very bottom. And it's Elaine. Other than that,
catfish. Bottom feeder.
other than Elaine, and I don't dislike. Like, it's Elaine, and then it's Martell.
Oh, yeah. Martell is lower than low.
Martell, I think Kelly, that'll show you. Hey, Kelly, I'm sorry. But Terry, I think that'll show you, that so you understand. So Martell and Elaine can switch for me.
Yeah.
They switch on a day. But just because Married to Medicine has gone off and we're fresh off of that, by the time Huntsville comes back on, then he'll switch down there. But them two definitely right there for me.
Yeah, and you know what's so sad about it is she embarrassed her husband so bad. You know, daddy, I do daddy.
With the daddy. But I think that people feel like I saw someone say something about Sweet Tea, like you don't like them because you like Sweet Tea. I wish people would stop putting words in my mouth. I never said I don't like Quad. I never said that. People are like, but because I can speak on Quad, like everybody speaks on everybody else, that doesn't mean
exactly
I can't speak on Letitia. Like if she
I like Letitia.
Yeah.
I like Lakeisha. You know, she is like just raw.
Somebody said something on my TikTok, telling me Melody, you always talk about what everybody else does. You don't talk about what Melody does. Well, what has she done? Has she done it?
Exactly.
Because if she's done something, I'll speak about it.
Exactly.
I mean, I don't see her doing number packaging up products and, you know, going to functions.
They hate it because that woman is private with her love life. That's all.
Personality speaking said, can I say I don't like Quad because I don't? Absolutely, you can say that.
Mm-hmm.
You absolutely can say it, and you can say it with your full chest. Because if that is how you feel, that is how you feel.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like Elaine, if she would, like they've already said that she's not going to show her life. She's not going to show her life. Because Carlos was saying when he was piggybacking with Toya and Simone, he was saying that the reason he loved season 5 so much is because everybody gave story. Well, you're never going to get story from Elaine. Never. Mm-hmm.
Not with that infamil with her lying self talking about daddy. Remember? And Sweet T said it. You had that grandbaby.
Exactly. I would be, yeah. Alexandra said after Martell, she'd be private too with her love life. Exactly. Because whenever Mel steps out with her mister, oh my God.
It's going to be over. Martell,
don't. You think Ariane has been acting up. She's going to go crazy because Martell going to lose his mind.
Exactly. Exactly. You know, she probably know how he is. You know, he's just, I don't know what it is about Martell. When they first came on, I liked them as a couple. And but now, you know, all the things that he did, and I don't see how in the world he expect for a woman to stay with him after you've been cheating with this girl for 5 years, got a baby, and now you mad at her for moving on and changing her name. And then he get to studying.
It's insane. It's really insane. It's really crazy.
And talking about the Fletchers. How y'all gonna be going to her thing? And y'all was supposed to be my friend first. Boy, grow up.
That is wild, that my friend first stuff. And we at this big age. If you are older than 16, you should not be doing that.
Exactly.
And like Alexandra said, things of that nature.
Exactly.
You should not. If you are older than 16, you maybe 18, maybe 18. Because once you get to college and once you get to working, you get a new life.
Exactly. And you change completely.
And you change friends.
You don't even have no friends.
38, 46, 50, 48, 39, talking about my friend. You supposed to be my friend and not her friend?
Exactly.
That is insane.
Exactly.
I have different friends. I don't mix friends. At all. I don't mix friends. That's how I keep, if you would talk to my friends, you would find out that I'm a very neutral friend.
Mm-hmm. I can tell you.
Like, I'm the one that everybody asks, how is so-and-so doing? Because I still talk to so-and-so.
I can tell you.
And they don't. So, I don't mix friends. I know I can't have my high school friends mixing with some of my friends that I work with or my college friends. Because I'm not a babysitter.
Exactly.
So, when I go into a room and you're in there, I'm going to need you there to do your thing. Because I don't have time to sit there and say, are you okay? Is everything all right? What you doing?
That's what Martell wants.
Because if I do it, because I can sit here and be talking to you, and I can see somebody walking the door, and I'll be back. And when I say I'll be back, I don't know when I'm coming back. Because I am a social butterfly.
Mm-hmm. So, and then, you know what? And Marcel, is it Martell, Marcel, whatever, Keisha's husband, shoot. He is one ugly bottom teeth, top teeth having self. He always want to contact women.
Oh yeah, Marcel is a mess.
You know, and Keisha know her husband cheats.
And Marcel might be on this line.
Well, come on with it.
Hey, Marcel.
Hey, Marcel, you go to court today? But they don't talk about, girl, they was on that darn reunion talking about they millionaires. Oh, you mean, you remember?
I was like, I just don't even understand how they throw that word around like that.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't understand how they throw that millionaire word around like that. I mean, because perception is everything.
Everything. Right?
It's everything. You can be whoever you want to be. I can get up here and get me a new unit, get me a new outfit, and spend my last few dollars on a plane ticket to go somewhere tropical. And y'all, you know, people be like, oh, Millie Chan just bit. You know what I'm saying? You don't know what Millie Chan had to do to get that done.
Exactly. And you know, people
can't be millionaires, can't even finish a house. Millionaires have lived in six houses. That's nothing. Exactly. Like Marcel, I don't want to see y'all moving no more.
Exactly. And I don't want to see that you took all that lady's stuff and put it in your house.
and for the people in the bushes who want to tell me that I'm too invested, just like you invested over here in this live in all those posts. Let me say this. These people put their lives out. Not scamminaires.
Scamminaires, is that what you said?
these people put their lives out here. Like 10 years ago, when we were watching whatever we were watching, what was on 10 years ago? This is 24, so it's been 2014. What was we watching?
Oh, we were watching Housewives of Atlanta.
Okay. Before we got
Housewives.
Okay, before we got, well, how we watched Housewives of Atlanta, before Instagram and all this stuff came up, all we knew is that Kim was dating a married man. She was buying trucks, changing clothes in the gas station parking lot. Her and Nene was cool.
Yep.
What's her name?
Deshaun Snow.
Sheree was trying to get her money. We didn't know nothing else that was going on after them cameras went down. We didn't know about them out at the club. We didn't know about them being socialites. We didn't know anything. But now, I literally be minding my business. And I'll get fine. And here go, something has happened. So here I go talking about it. But then you want to say, I'm too invested because I'm speaking against someone that you may like. It's called an opinion. I am.
Everybody has one.
I'm a content creator. This is what I do.
If you don't like how she puts it out, then you can go to another channel.
Yeah.
You know, people are just so, you know, you got your millimeters, which I like. Melanie, I don't have no reason to dislike her because she's a woman that scorned, you know, and she got herself up and look where she is now.
And then like, okay, and then like with the millimeters, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like that's, those people, I think the millimeters is exactly what male needs because like when I go live and when I talk to you all, when I go live on TikTok, you all are exactly what we need in those moments because I really don't move without TikTok. if I got something going on, that's where I go. The millimeters do just that for male, right?
Yep.
they are exactly what she needs to keep going. Like I've always said, y'all don't understand how powerful you are. The fact that 232 people are in here, up to 300 people, you all did that for me. I'm an author because of you. I am a content creator. I get indoors because of you all. I don't think y'all understand how important you are. We have to have you. We have to. Mel loves her millimeters. I love my Millie crew. If they
come up with a nickname,
I'm on the road traveling. I honestly need to be asleep right now. But because I know how my days go, I have to give y'all at least 2 hours of my time just to connect.
Right.
And I know y'all connect with me with my post, but I have to give you this extra time because that's important to me.
Girl, when I get notification of your hot topics, I get my ear pod out and put you under my desk. Not under my desk, but under my laptop, my computer.
Yeah.
And pray a patient don't come up. And like, I'm like, dang, I can't
hear it. But what I'm saying is they get mad at Mel because Mel had mentioned something about how they were saying something about the millimeters and they need to pull the mail. First of all, the people that have decided to support Mel the way they support Mel are adults. They have made a conscious decision that this girl has gone through way more than I've gone through, or she's gone through the same thing I've gone through. And the thing is, she's gone through it publicly.
Yep.
And we have just, we feel a certain way. So whatever we can do, if we need to buy some face wash, we gonna buy some face wash. Just like
and some,
I need y'all to go buy my 2 books because I'm writing my 3rd one. If y'all buy one of my 2 books, you just buy it because you want to.
I got to get them because I like to read.
But my whole thing is, then you get mad because ain't nobody checking for you. Maurice, nobody is checking for you. Marceau, you need to be checking for you. I ain't going to even say that. I was about to say something else. But
that big wide back.
The thing is, Mel shows you her life. She's not lying, right? And I'll show you mine. I'm not lying about what I got going on. If it's not a good day, it's just not a good day. Mel gets quiet. One thing we do know about Mel, when she gets quiet, she's working on something. And when she pop out, is out. But then you got Letitia with
ain't
the
doing nothing.
Squad. And she not telling the truth on the daily. Girl, you have to have, I love who the millimeters are for Melody Cherie Rogers. Because she needs that support.
As a woman, nobody can understand what she went through.
She needs that support. And if it's just a live, if y'all are just going to the live to listen to it, you come to this live to listen to it. I don't think people understand that. And even people that go against me, oh my gosh, she did this. Girl, if you have been cheated on and your husband had a baby, because I will say this to the end, nobody knows how that girl feels when she clicks off that live, when Lauren leaves, when Jay is not around, when she's not traveling. When she get into bed and her kids are with Martell this week, she understands why her kids are with Martell this week. Because her husband has embarrassed her forever. It is forever on television. So you have to support her to keep her mind right. I don't understand why people can't do it. I don't understand how women don't understand it. And I'm not saying Mel is perfect. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying she's the best. I'm not saying that. Those are the two, Rose Without a Thorn and Rose in the Wind. But I'm not saying that. But the thing is, she does stuff. She's not perfect. She messes up.
Yeah.
Right now, she minds her business and she does her business. If you know,
teacher's jealous of her.
I just don't understand.
And Kimmy, you know, I'm so sick. They better not come back with the show talking about the bang bang. You know, I'm sick of it. I'm sick of the bang bang.
Yeah, Alexandra, I'm with you on that. And yes, like Maurice, we don't want to hear nothing about no libido. We don't want to hear nothing about no credit fixing. We don't want to hear anything about that.
Girl, I'd be scared to go to him for credit fixing. Shoot, you get my social security number.
And look, just like I Am Heaven Spillman said, he broke her heart. You can tell her heart was broke on that first season whatever season that was that Kimmy and Maurice got married and they were on that boat and they was outside talking about it. You could tell her heart was broken.
Yeah.
Because then he sat there and lied to her face.
Exactly.
Like, we've been talking a year. She was like, really? Okay, we've been talking 2 years. You've been talking to this woman for 2 years?
And you know,
and then it got to the point, people love to hold on to the fact that Mel would call Ariane or she went to Ariane's house. You don't know what state of mind she was in. Now, I don't think I would have done that.
Me neither.
But you don't know what she was thinking. She probably was trying to figure out, who is this woman? Like, why is she with my husband? Why is my husband caught up? She got to do what she got to do for her mindset.
Exactly.
Because if you really pay attention to season one, you know what's going on, because Martell cheating came up so quick in one of them confessionals. It came up so quick. Mel was over it then. She was over it.
She was. And you know, the sad part about it is, like, when they went off this season, and you remember when Melanie met with Martell, and she said, he got mad because she said, well, I sent some food with the kids when they came, but don't do that. He was like, don't do that.
Now, he doesn't like to be embarrassed. He's not a man who likes to be embarrassed at all. Like, he doesn't like it. That's why Martell just kind of stays in the bushes. Mm-hmm. He's not going, because it's like he's done these things, but he wants you to say, okay, it's done and it's over. But you got the domino effect behind you doing it always leads back to you and what you've done. He just can't
see it. Like the lawsuit that he got from not fixing those people's house.
Girl. This is what I'm saying. If I was a young woman, I know y'all have heard me say this before, and I was getting ready to move to Huntsville, Alabama, and somebody showed me that show, I would pack my bags and go in a different direction. Because the three men that they have representing that city, and I know how great that city is. I went to school in that city. But those three men would deter me from moving. Because if I thought that's what is out, if I thought I could just get a half of that, I don't want it.
Mm-mm.
I don't want it. I don't want it.
I don't either. I don't understand. Remember when Melanie told Marcel, you just gonna get mad when Keisha get that money and leave your ass.
But see, and that's the thing. Why you over here bothering me and she done put all her stuff out? That's why I said, since you over here, let's talk about it.
Exactly. You know what? I think Marcel got a crush on Melanie.
Everybody feels like that. But it's always... Men always want what they can't have.
They have
something different. Like, he know he can go home and tell Tisha to be quiet, and she gonna be quiet. But he can't do that to Mel. You know what I'm saying? He not gonna be able to do that. Wait a minute. This is the last time I'm gonna talk about this. If he can walk in the house and say, "I'm going to Africa by myself," and it actually happens, He better stay with Tisha.
Stay in Africa. He come back home, won't be a home.
He better stay with her for life, because they don't make any more of them like that. I'm sorry. Because you can't come here talking about you. I need to know if you go to the gas station.
Exactly.
And ask me if I want to ride. If I don't go, that's because I said no. Not because you done told me no.
Exactly. And, you know, they've been building that house with those bricks, and now they moved in back into the other house where they finished, where he just took everybody else's stuff to make that house. It's sad. And, you know, and people always talk about my marriage.
Wait, real quick. Wait a minute. Let's move on from that. Let's talk about Yeah, Terry, the gas station. I don't know, Sonya, why he doesn't have smoke for coleslaw, or I don't know why. It got that's so crazy.
Connor. I don't even eat coleslaw no more.
You know what? I do want to move on from Love and Marriage Huntsville, but let me tell you, that is crazy that people have coined that name for her. She mm-hmm. should, let me tell you, Ariana, if you're in the bushes, let me tell you what you need to do. You need to go over to Popeyes, because I heard that's what y'all like to eat too. You need to go on over to Popeyes, and you need to figure out how you can get something.
Market with yourself.
How are you not doing a coleslaw commercial?
Exactly. But you know, Melanie was the one that did had the minds, and she can market the heck out of herself. Marcel couldn't tell. I mean, Martell couldn't show her nothing.
Let me tell you this. And Terry is correct. She said it's crazy. You give her so many ideas. I have
lip gloss. Mm-hmm.
Like girl.
And what she do?
The whole world.
Stop selling those clothes from AliExpress.
I cannot. But I'm just saying, if the whole world has coined her as coleslaw, because literally anybody that's in the Love and Marriage Huntsville bubble, if you're in this bubble, and it's a lot of us, mm-hmm. you know exactly who that is. And you never had a thought. They say Martell over here like Popeyes. Martell, let's go to Popeyes and let's do a commercial for coleslaw. Let me call the marketing department. Let me call the marketing department and let them know that my likeness is hooked up with Love and Marriage Huntsville, which is a great show on television.
Mm-hmm. And I was coleslaw. I'm coleslaw.
You want to sit here and talk about you the number one mistress in the world. You need to get paid for it.
Exactly. You're not getting nothing but
us
a mattress.
I saw Elaine with her shirt on.
You did?
Uh-huh. Tim said I would have been selling coleslaw in Walmart like Pat LaBelle. I know that's right.
Exactly. You know, you're so happy when he even get on Instagram with you. You know.
She didn't even know what to talk about.
Mm-mm. She just grinning.
Bless her heart, Jesus.
And but, is it true he slapped her at the gym?
I don't know. I was not there. I don't even know where that came from.
Mm. If it's true,
I know.
And you still with that man? You crazy girl. Pack your bags. You must with your two-parent household.
Exactly. You sit right here wearing Bath & Body Works lip gloss. You need to have a Bath & Body Works situation going on.
Exactly.
You need to have Bath & Body Works lip gloss in the back of your... I mean, you put it on every 5 minutes.
Every five minutes.
They need to know. But look, y'all, we moving on. We moving on because I'm going to be off in like we got about 15 more minutes. What do y'all feel about the Kenya Moore? How you feel about Kenya Moore? In Love and Marriage, I mean, in Real Housewives of Atlanta coming back, what are we thinking for the overall situation? Because well, I feel like
she's gonna be lost.
I really and truly am nervous for the Real Housewives of Atlanta. I really am. I'm nervous. I'm nervous.
You know, Kenya probably feels some type of way because she know Portia came back and she's probably making more than her.
Tammy says she's not watching. Okay, that's another question. Are you watching it this season? I don't even know if they're filming.
Oh, Lord. Oh, she just said Elaine's getting kind of big again, I guess, Jamie.
Oh, Erica said not watching. Oh.
It'll be kind
of... She said I'm watching.
Yeah, I'm watching just to see what Kenya's gonna do.
It is gonna be interesting.
She don't have nobody because you know Portia gonna come back on her. You know she say something. Portia ought to feel so bad coming. You know, I understand she need to make her coins, as she said.
plot twist. That would be a good plot twist.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody said, child, Portia got Candy's salary.
Yep. And Kenya's, you know, made it.
You know, I mean, I hate to keep talking about this, but it was just crazy. Like, I literally... Hold on, they need me back. I literally could not understand. Like, if you go down Kenya's timeline, like, she's not the most honest. I hope Martell not back on there, Britt.
Oh, Housewives.
Yeah. She said she hadn't watched since Nene was on there. And look at Erica. You see what I'm talking about? Like, I have to watch it. Because Erica said she needs the updates. So, what I'm not going to watch it? Because y'all need the updates.
And you then, know we're all going to be watching to see what these new people do. They should have got that lady that husband, she caught her husband cheating in the airport. Remember? She did a whole story and she lived in Atlanta. That's who needs to be on there.
I had shirts made. I have shirts that said Team Gail on my Teespring account. I have it linked to my website on milichun.com. Oh, you can go to milichun.com also to get my books.
Milichun.com.
All right. It'll pop up in the shop. You can go there to get the books. Gail will be great. But Gail can't talk until the divorce is final. Oh. She popped out there and she got us salivating at the mouth.
Yeah.
But then she had to come back at the end. I think her last video about that was like things are happening and she can't really say anything until the divorce is final. I think he might put a little bit of gag order on her.
Yeah. You know he did. You know, when you talk cheating. You know. And you know, I heard Sheree was talking about her mom has dementia.
Oh yeah. I meant to talk about that. That is so sad.
That is.
You know, her father passed away from that.
Yeah, my mother passed away with dementia.
My grandmother passed away from that. And so
I had to quit my job and move home because I'm my only child. Mm-hmm. And I came here because my stepdad was laying in the bed, passed away. My mama didn't even know it.
Oh, wait a minute. No, girl.
Mm-hmm. I came over to their house because I had been sick and the doctor released me. And I came over and I was like trying to get in the door and bamming on the doors and stuff. And my mom, I said, Mom, it's me. So she let me in. And
you know the hardest part about that is that, like, with Sheree's concern, like, you know, they say Sheree's house is in her mom's name and things like that. And then she has to deal with that during the show.
Yeah. Because she's just going to be a friend, right?
Oh.
Sheree.
I don't know. But I'm with you, Kelly. Gail would be a good fit for the Real Housewives of Atlanta because she would be a fresh face. She would be of a certain age bracket. And I think people could really, because people saw her story, I think they could really, really, really
relate.
Relate to her, for real relate to her. And then you have Portia, who we've seen before. You got Kenya and Drew for the younger crowd. I think it would be great.
Yep.
Drew does not give me everything she needs to give me, but I think she has a story.
She does have a story. You know what? I say this. Sometimes I think Drew and Ralph are still together.
Oh, my God.
I really do think that because they're still living in the house together.
Shamia, you know what? Shamia not going to be on the show. Shamia is going to be a friend to the show because Shamia doesn't want to give her life like that.
Right, because I remember that's what happened the first time.
Yeah, she don't want to give her life like that. Shamia ain't got no problem going on a trip.
No, I know that's right. Remember when she asked?
Thank you,
Nikita. What's her name? Did you used to be Miss Elliot's girlfriend?
Yeah, she don't have no problem getting on. She don't have no problem going on trips, putting on a swimsuit. She don't have any problem with that. But when y'all come back, I'm going home to my husband.
Exactly.
And y'all stay on over there.
Cameras can't come inside.
Kelly said she believes Drew and Ralph are still together too.
Yep, I really do. You know, but what I can't get over with Kenya, though, That is the longest divorce I ever seen in my life. I don't believe that story, not one bit.
Well, I can believe it because mine was long like that. I had, it was 2011 to 2014. It was crazy.
Oh,
it was real crazy. And with everything, it ended up in mediation. Just like that, it was over. We could have
We could have done that
day 10.
Exactly. Well, shoot, mine was quick and easy. Shoot. Oh boy, you got to go.
Yeah. But yeah, it's over now. So okay, so what, Kenya? If you're in the bushes, Kenya, what we don't want to hear about, anything about Mark Daly, because it's done. But what we do want to see is you in this hair care spa. P.S. If y'all saw her commercial on her Instagram post, allegedly the girl that was in the pink dress giving that girl their hair scalp treatment, that's Kenya's assistant.
Oh, it is. She's going to be a friend to the show, right? She was with her.
I'm talking about she's not a hairdresser.
She's just an assistant.
She does not have a cosmetology license.
Oh my goodness.
She did it for the post, allegedly. No, Kelly, it's not real. I went to it and it wasn't open. And recently, March 7th, Michelle Brown went to it and she had an appointment at 4:00. And the salon closes at 7:00 and it was locked when she got there with the box.
Oh my goodness.
But I will say this. When I went, there were posters and butcher paper. Now there is no more poster and butcher paper. So it's a progress. I'm going to give a positive.
Maybe she waiting to have it open when they film.
Yeah. And see, she never came out. She never came out and said anything. Until she got her contract.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like if she hadn't got her contract, we still wouldn't have heard anything about Kenya Moore hair care.
Remember when she first came out and Shamil said it was water in the bottle?
You see, Kelly said she did see Michelle's video. She went up there, she recorded herself, going to the door. She had an appointment at 4:00. The door was closed. Locked.
Mm. I hope she didn't have to put something down for that hair appointment.
Somebody asked that question. And I don't remember her answering it. I don't remember what she said about it. But I feel like when we're hitting up our mark, I do want to see Brooklyn. I do like to see mothers with their kids. Like even Giselle. Although Giselle on Potomac has no storyline, I do love to see her with her girls.
Oh yeah.
Even Elaine, I love it. When Elaine is with Alara, I can almost stand her.
Yeah, she's different.
She's different when she's with Alara. I love it when they're with their kids. Right.
Alara is just like
Garcelle. I love Garcelle Bouvier with her boys. I love that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really do. Wait a minute. This wasn't even on the topic, I don't think. I think Kyle and Maurice, that was a storyline for her.
No, I don't think so. She devastated, girl. Like, yeah, it definitely was a storyline. But I've heard that Kyle may not even be back.
Because I feel like
if Kyle doesn't come back next season, that's going to be the season of divorce. And I feel like she's going to come back the season after that, and it'll be done. Stop. This is the last thing I'm going to talk about. When I saw Corey say she by Sheree. Y'all, I'm about to wrap this up. We got 6 minutes. Did y'all see my post with GNA?
Yes, Lord.
Giselle and Ashley. Yes, I heard about Karen. When I get off of here, I'm going to go and see what's going on, and I'll post about that in a minute. I was asleep, child. I didn't know. Y'all, I promise. But I'm going to get on it. Y'all, did y'all see the post? Joni, it's on my page. Hey, Danielle. $45 for a beanie. Look, $45 for a beanie and $42 for a sweatshirt.
She must rate price.
$32 for a tank top, but $26 for a t-shirt. And then, like I said, there are no tights. You got beanies, you got caps, you got sweatshirts, you got t-shirts, tank tops. But you have no tights?
That's what you...
Ashley talked about how she sweats.
Yeah, crotch sweat.
Crotch sweat.
Which is...
And you don't have no tights?
Oh, you know what? We did, girl. Let me tell you.
All of those outfits that they came down the
runway is not on the.
It's just like She by Sheree.
Girl, wait a minute. I had to tell you this. Wendy with her lying self. She remember when she said her mama was in the hospital and had to have surgery?
Yeah.
Her mama told her that it was an elective thing and she'll be right after the same day.
15 minutes.
And then she go, my mom was in the hospital. You know, I don't like Wendy.
Now, anything, let me say this, because you know anything can happen to somebody in the hospital. But I do understand where you're going. Because Giselle's daddy had brain situation and her mama had probably a boob job that could have gone wrong.
Exactly.
It's not the same. It's not no. the same. And I didn't want to make it seem like I meant it to be the same in my post. But the only thing that was the same for me was the fact they were under anesthesia. That's it.
Exactly.
And exactly. Anything can happen under anesthesia.
Yeah, I don't know how Wendy's mom is, but yeah.
I'm gonna say I'm not a Wendy fan at all. Ooh,
I'm not either. I'm not a Wendy's fan because Wendy is she's just so fake.
I think Wendy should have come to us like she did her second season. Because exactly. Who she is now is who she is. And who she came in with all these degrees, that's why I don't understand why people don't. I don't understand it. I understand you have to have something for your storyline or something you think people want to hear your storyline. But,
mm-hmm. Yeah, but you know, saying, I Jolie. Personally that's think she's jealous of that. She's that's jealous of that girl.
Yeah. That's why I said that, Joni, because things like that happen, like with Kanye West's mom. By no means was I trying to compare Giselle and Wendy's parents' surgery together because it was not the same. It was not the same. But if anybody's parent goes to the hospital and they're not home, you're going to have that same feeling. So I understood what Wendy was saying in that moment. But because your mother may have wanted her nose done or her boobs done or something like that, it's not having... Yes, he did. He passed last year.
Yeah.
It's not having brain cancer or brain aneurysm or whatever, you know, because she lost her father.
Yep.
So and Giselle lost her dad. So yeah, mm-hmm. By no means were I trying to make light of it. The only thing that I was saying that's in comparison is that they had to go under anesthesia. That's it.
That's it. And but Wendy, you know, my mom was in the hospital and she had surgery. And she laughed. Girl, bye.
But let me just get back on these clothes. Because I understand this. Is anybody buying GNA? And what is that name?
Giselle and Ashley.
But what is that? Like, oh my God, really? That's what you come up with?
Mm. Did you get the post I sent you? I DM'd you when Ashley was getting her dress made.
Yes. Let me say this, y'all. Ashley Darby has never, from neck to feet, looked this good ever.
Uh-huh.
I think after I went back and looked at it, Ashley's hair was a bit too big.
Yeah.
It was a bit too big. It was. But
she had that designer. That's that black lady in Baltimore that used to do dresses for, what's her name? Monique Samuels.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Same designer.
Yeah. She killed it. Like
she killed it.
Her dress was just absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
And
y'all, this has been absolutely wonderful.
Yes. Just
wonderful. And thank you all for all being here. Please hit the like button before you leave. I feel like that too. It should have been up. I feel like her hair should have been up. I really
did. Yeah. Oh yeah.
And I feel like maybe a sleek ponytail or something like that. Maybe a bun. I don't know. But I feel like it should have been up.
Yeah.
What you talking about, Danielle? With Riley, what? Oh, Riley was the designer for the dress?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
I couldn't think of the name, but I remember.
Yeah, she did so good. But y'all, thank y'all so much. Don't forget,
yeah, girl.
Please like this. Send people to subscribe to the channel. And I'm going to go ahead and check. I'm going to go ahead and check on Karen.
Yeah, you know, I got one of your sorors.
Oh, wait a minute, channel. I'm going to let you finish, but let me say this. If there are any sorors in here, y'all be on the lookout because I'm going to have, if you're coming to Boule, I'm going to have a Boule bash that is in the works right now as of today. So just keep a lookout for it if you're coming. Yes, a sleek ponytail.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead. What you were saying, Sam?
I met one of your sorors, and I got her to start watching your channel. I said, girl, you need to be watching Middle Channel.
Thank you.
She AKA too. She sat there. She was in the lobby because waiting on her husband all the time. And we would talk like we was on a network channel. I said, girl, you see this and you see that? I said, but you need to be watching Middle Channel. And she's like, okay. Subscribe to your channel.
Oh, thank you. Well, I really appreciate it. And and like I said, and you know, like somebody asked about the books. I want you to buy them. I just don't like to push because I just know people, but I appreciate what you are, how you all support me. I appreciate it so much. So much.
Yeah, you my girl from Texas.
So much. But you can go to milichun.com and all the things are there. And I'm gonna talk to y'all later. I'm gonna say what all I can do about this. Where is Bell Collective right now? I'm gonna think on it and see how I can put it in motion for you all.
So call us. What do you need to be doing?
Yeah. I love y'all. Y'all have a good week. And I'm about to go over here and check on
Karen.
I'm working on it. I'm trying to work on it. But I'm about to get ready to go ahead and check on Karen.
Yeah.
I'll talk to y'all later.
Okay, take care, girl. Bye-bye.
Y'all have a
good one. Bye, everybody.
Bye.